in addition to aerobatics, Vicky got racing. A friend of mine here came to me and said, in her first year of racing, Vicky was chosen as rookie of the year. About when we get him in the air later this afternoon. And then we hand things over this afternoon at 2:30 to the Thunderbirds to complete our air display and rehearsal here at day one. There's Vicky Benzing, get down the show line there. Give her a huge wave of appreciation for a job well done. Get a chance to talk to her, please. She will inspire you as Bob Crompton and his jet-powered glider is being slowly pulled out. And it will be performing for us a little later this afternoon. It is my pleasure to introduce you to Captain John Culver and War Dog, his North American War Dog. This year, celebrating 40 years of thrilling audiences with their air show performance across the West Coast. Big round Pratt & Whitney engine, and another. John started at 16 and soloed 5 different types of airplanes. His aerobatic career started at 74, the age of 19. The International Aerobatic Club competition, where he achieved high rankings in their Gold Cup championships. He continued to advance his career when at age 26, he formed his own aerobatic training school out of Hawthorne, California. Then 2 years later, inspired by his father, a World War II veteran, John began to fly War Dog. He flew his air show in Porterville, 1982, for the first time as a tribute to those from the greatest generation. Northrop Grumman, he became a captain who flew such notables as Vice President Dick Cheney and Aviation Disney. Walt Disney designed Ferdinand the Bull, a red bull with small wings, as El Toro base mascot. In reciprocation, the Marines painted Walt Disney's initials, WD, on the aircraft based at El Toro. When John acquired War Dog, he chose to restore her to her original paint scheme from her El Toro days. The green sculpture. Branches of the military, the T-6 Texan trained more military pilots than any other airplane in history. It gave the best possible training in all types of tactics, from ground scraping to bombardment and aerial dogfighting and instrument training, as this one did. More than 15,000 examples were produced. The last model was produced in early 1950s. Again, a tribute to our veterans in War Dog. Let's just listen to the sound. And that prop biting into the sky at supersonic speed. side to side to give you a great look and a wave to you and another thank you from this historic airplane.